Hi viewers, in this video I am going to show you about the hemoglobin electrophoresis, which is used in the diagnosis of the sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell hemoglobin is a mutant version of the normal hemoglobin. In the normal hemoglobin, you can see at the 6th amino acid, GAG nucleotide, GAG codon, which codes for the glutamate. Glutamate is a negatively charged amino acid. Whereas the change in the A to T of 6th codon will change the amino acid to valine, and this valine is a nonpolar or near neutral amino acid or less negatively charged amino acid. Hence, the normal hemoglobin, which is having the glutamate at the 6th place, will have high negativity, whereas the sickle hemoglobin, which has the valine at 6th amino acid, will have lesser negativity. So this principle, this charge difference, we are going to use as the basic principle for the detection of hemoglobin trait, sickle cell trait versus the sickle cell disease individual. So in this picture, you can see the hypothetical parents, so who are having the both heterozygous condition. So if both the parents contribute normal hemoglobin, the individual will be, the children will be normal. If both are not contributing the same, that means one is contributing the normal, other is contributing the sickle hemoglobin, then this person will be the trait. And both the parents contributes the sickle hemoglobin, then it will be called as a SCA, sickle cell anemia, or the homozygous sickle cell disease. So the basic principle, I told, the charge differences in the hemoglobins. These hemoglobins can be separated in the electric field with the electrophoresis technique. So here, what are the instruments required? So instruments required is mainly power pack and the electrophoresis unit, horizontal electrophoresis unit. In addition to that, forceps, pipette, centrifuges, 15 ml tubes, beakers, applicator, and these two instruments. So the reagents required. So we need normal saline, hemolyzing agent, that is carbon tetrachloride, distilled water, Tris EDTA boric acid buffer, that is called TEB buffer, or TBE or TEB, anything you can call, and it is pH is 8.4, and this can be made with Tris 10.2 grams, EDTA 0.6 grams, and boric acid 3.6 grams, and you have to make up this to 1 liter. So for staining the proteins, you can use 0.5% Ponzi S stain dissolved in TCA 5%. So TCA is a corrosive, and you should wear the gloves while preparing this protein staining solution. So the de-staining solution, generally the de-staining solution 5% acetic acid in the methanol we use, and this can be used as a de-staining solution. So the procedure mainly two, you can divide it into two parts. One is hemolyzed preparation, second one is resolving in the electrophoresis. So for hemolyzed preparation, you have to take 2 ml of buffer, and you have to mix 3 volumes of normal saline, and you have to centrifuge this at 3000 rpm, and you have to discard the supernatant. So this procedure you have to repeat 2 to 3 times to remove the excess of proteins, other cells, all other debris, everything. So now at the end of the third centrifuge with the cell line, normal cell line, then you will be getting a concentrate of the RBCs. So now at the second step is the lysis. So for lysis, to facilitate the lysis, you can add few drops of carbon tetrachloride, 4 to 5 drops of carbon tetrachloride, and 1 ml of distilled water. And again, you have to centrifuge this at 3000 rpm and for 3 minutes, and now we have to collect the supernatant. Till now we have discarded the supernatant, now we are going to collect the supernatant. This supernatant will have the hemoglobin that came out of the RBCs. So the preparation of the cellulose esterate strip. So now you have the lysate, now you have to apply on the cellulose esterate strip. cellulose acetate strip can be procured from the market, and this cellulose acetate strip you have to soak in the TEB or TEB, that is tris-acetic acid and borate, tris-borate and EDTA buffer. So this is electrophoresis buffer, and this we are using that in the tank, so that you have to soak this in the this one for some time, and you have to wipe out the excess of water, and using a pencil you have to mark the loading place. So you have to put a straight line at the at one end of the strip. Over the pencil markings you have to apply your sample. This is the pencil marking, this which indicates the origin. So sample origin you are going to apply on this particular license. So now the moist strips can be used for applying the sample. So now apply the sample on a penciled origin line using a small plastic strip, which is called as the applicator. Now you have to just simply touch the hemolysate and then apply it on the paper, cellulose acetate paper. Now electrophoresis. So now you have to take the strip and put it in the electrophoresis unit. So electrophoresis unit, you have already poured the buffer and made the paper wicks. So with this paper wicks, on the over the paper wicks, you have to keep this particular cellulose acetate strip. So press the ends of the strip firmly against the pad to ensure the paper contact. Now the entire circuit is connected. Now connect the leads, power leads. So that at positive and negative terminals power supply you just give, so that electrophoresis will be carried out at a constant voltage of 200 volts for 20 minutes. So after running, because these are the RBC proteins, so that slightly you can see the red in color, you can see the movement with the naked eye also, but to ensure that it is a protein band or not, then you have to stain it. So staining and destaining protocol you have to follow. So now the remove the strip from the electrophoresis unit with the forceps and immerse the strip completely in the Poncius stain and leave it for 5 minutes. So the next step is now the all the protein bands that are resolved on the cellulose acetate paper will absorb the stain, and excess of the stain will be removed by immersing this particular strip in the 5% acetic acid or the destaining solution. So change the acetic acid repeatedly, or take some few different beakers which is having the 5% acetic acid is a destaining solution. Dip in each one. That means rinse it properly with the destaining solution. Finally, wash it with the water and label this paper and store for appropriate time. So you can sometimes wrap with a plastic sheet also, plastic paper also. You can envelope the paper, plastic paper, so that it will not fade out. So this can be used for viewing the this one. So how to score the bands? Homozygous AA and homozygous SS individuals will yield only one band. So that means sickle hemoglobin will be migrating very slowly. So this band is the slow moving band. This is the site of application. You applied here sample. So this is the negative end. The protein has migrated towards the positive site, and the faster movement band is called as the AA. If it is a single band, faster moving band, that is AA. A single band with a slow movement, then it is SS. And if any sample forms two bands, one is corresponding to the fast moving band, the other one is corresponding to the slow moving band, then you can call that as AS. So whenever you are performing a test, you have to use at least one known heterozygous samples which can yield two different bands. So if your sample is corresponding to the fast moving band, then you can say that AA. If it is corresponding to the slow moving band, that is SS. If it forms two bands, then you can assign to that sample as AS, a trait or carrier kind of thing. This is the way you have to score the bands of the electrophoresis. So the limitations. So some of the hemoglobins which have the similar mobilities, HBD, HBE, So that type of things cannot be separated. HBS, HBD also you cannot separate. So that means if you want to use this particular technique to separate the HBD from the HBS, you cannot use this particular technique. So the identification of bands, HB variants, the other hemoglobin variants will always depends on the quality of separation and relative positioning. So generally to differentiate the A from the S, you may need only just 5 to 10 minutes, maximum 20 minutes or half an hour. So if you want to get high resolution or so many variants, if you want to identify, you need to run longer time and longer band, longer time you have to use it, and fresh reagents you have to use it. So hemoglobin concentration, amperage, that is buffer strength, running temperature, and length of the electrophoresis run will be deciding the resolution of the bands. Generally, many labs use alkaline electrophoresis. Some labs also use the hemoglobin electrophoresis, acid hemoglobin electrophoresis on the cellulose acetate paper. So for your understanding, I want to show the differences between the acid electrophoresis and alkaline electrophoresis. Till now, we have discussed about the alkaline electrophoresis, where the A band, that is the normal band, is moving faster than the sickle band. Whereas in the acid electrophoresis, which is pH 6.2, so sickle band will move faster than the normal band. So altogether, reverse pattern you will be getting with the acid electrophoresis compared to the this one. So with this, I'll conclude my presentation. And if you like my video, please share, like, and subscribe. Thank you.